Hey guys, and welcome back to Beardchanics Garage. In this one, I'm going to show you how the gearbox works on the Audi S3 8V. This was actually requested by one of you guys, which unfortunately got his A3 into an accident and is now basically looking to buy a S3. So I thought we will do a little demonstration on how the various driving modes you have, but also how you put it in manual and how the manual system works. Alright, so you've got your little type select here, or you can program this one to also you do your drive select, as you can see. Now we bring it back. If you can do air drive select from this button, it's exactly the same. So you can just keep on clicking the button to select one, or you can use this dial here. So you can pick efficiency, and now your car will be in efficiency mode. So if you put it in gear, as you can see, it's E01. So then you can change to comfort. The D, that's actually dynamic, because comfort doesn't actually change the gear. You can have full auto, which once again will be dynamic. Or you can pick dynamic. And you can hear dynamic here, it's already in S mode because it was already in dynamic. So basically, when you press dynamic twice, it put it in S mode, just the same way that if you pull the lever here. So if you look at now, I pull the lever, we are back to dynamic. I pull again, we are back to S1. And if you want to go in manual, it's as easy as switching this to the left. And now you can push and pull to change gear, or you can change gear here and here. One thing that is important to know is manual is always available. So here, as you can see here, we are in manual mode. If you were to be in this position, which is in dynamic, if you were to press on the paddle, the car will automatically switch to manual mode. Here it won't work because you're obviously static. So that's one thing, you know, you can have it in here. If you need a bit of control on the go, you can click switch in manual. After a while of not using manual, it will revert back to the mode you were on. One thing to know about the manual mode on an S3 is that downshift and upshift will occur automatically, but you know, when it's at redline. So in sport mode, you might hit 3500 RPM, even in sport, the gear will go up. In manual mode, it will only automatically upshift when you redline, which on mine is about 7000 RPM. One thing to remember as well, the gearbox will not remember sport mode. So if you are here in dynamic, you put yourself in sport, we switch off the car, and as you can see, it's back in dynamic mode. There is nothing you can do to actually have it start in sport mode all the time. So, you know, every time you start it up, basically, you've got to press down. And here you go, you're in sport mode. And that's pretty much it. That's pretty much all there is to know. Apart from, I guess I'll go through the dynamic mode. Efficiency mode is basically going to use on off a lot. Is going to want to basically, every time you let off the throttle, you will disengage the clutch to maximize efficiency. And that's pretty much it. Oh, and you won't have any pops and bang. Where in comfort, auto, dynamic, individual, they are all pretty much the same. The only main difference after is really the three modes you have is efficiency, dynamic, and sport when it comes to like rev and feel and stuff like that. And that's pretty much it, guys. You know, it's just a quick one to basically show all the position and things like that. And yeah, I'm going to move away. And here, I actually shot this in France. And by the time I arrived on park here, the police came and checked my car. And I actually got my papers checked and they checked my car before I could actually go and do this recording, you know. That's why I've always said, if you haven't watched my video about France and the French police, do be aware when you are in France, they do like to put their nose into your business. They were very nice, obviously I'm not doing anything wrong. They were very polite and moved on, but yeah, definitely, you know, not the same kind of police that we have in England. Anyway, guys, if you haven't subscribed yet, please do give us a like, give us a comment. It helps us grow. And see you in the next one.